What's up, people? It's your girl, Chrissy Renee. So what would you guys really think one day if the camera just popped on and it was like another thought standing here? Would you be like, Chrissy has changed a lot? Or would you be like, move over, ho, where is Thought to Miss Prime? That would be kind of funny, you know, the prank, you know, came and talked right, talking illiterate. You know, that would be a cool prank. I still got it. I'm smart when I need to be. So if you guys ain't heard the news, oh, we can get married. Oh my goodness, finally. And it's like kind of hard to believe, like, it's legit. Like, everybody can get married, which I don't understand why it was illegal in the first place. What does Peter and Bob have to do with Mary and Sam down the street? Like, are they paying your light bill? Nah. So why is you worrying about what they doing? Boo-boo, you need to worry about what your man is doing and worrying about what his man is doing, because he got his man, you know what I'm saying? I feel like the world that we live in, people worry about too much of what's going on in the other person's life. Now, boo, live your life and let them live their life. If they want to marry a dog, allow them to marry a dog. If they want to marry, you know, the same sex, let them. You know, like they say, you know, in the Bible, they say that's not right. It also says stop being a thot, too. But half of you girls don't know the lifestyle of a lady. I'm just saying, I'm not here to preach a sermon, but Jesus, all sins are equal. Everybody want to say, oh, it's wrong to be gay, or it's a sin to be gay, but it's like, it also says, you know, you don't supposed to have sex before marriage, and how many dudes you don't bump and grind, baby? You know, I don't want to put you on the spot. And you know, what lie did you just tell yesterday to get out of a date with the bitch that you don't like? You know, we don't supposed to tell a lie, Sam. Everybody want to just sit here and point fingers like, look what they doing. But baby, look what you doing. Like, you can't throw stones living in a glass house. I just feel like if somebody wants to be gay or bisexual, straight, or, you know, transgender or whatever, honey, allow them. It just makes me sad that they have to live, you know, lives, or there's people in the world who has to live lives in the closet because they're afraid of what the next chick gonna say. Like, that's a terrible life. Like, I live 18 years of my life of a confused, gentle boy, and I was miserable. Like, I tried to pretend to like this or like that because that's what I thought I was supposed to like. But no, boo, I was made to be a purple mermaid, you know, because purple is my favorite color. You know, I always like to wear purple. My nails ain't purple this time, but I'm about to hook them up. You know where your bitch is going tomorrow? San Diego Gay Pride. So, you know, I hope, you know, let the stars align that your girl find a baby daddy. Because, you know, a lot of my priorities are changing and my values are changing. I want a family ever since this gay marriage. You know, like, I'm excited, but I ain't really excited for the gay marriage because, you know, I ain't really got a boo yet. So I gotta go find me a boo. Hey, daddy. And you know, I just want to introduce myself. My name is Chrissy. What's up? You know what I'm saying? I'm just playing. You can't do that. You got to be like, hey. Now, that's the thought way. So you're just trying to be a thought. I just feel like, you know, I should just be myself and, you know, just introduce myself. But, you know, we're not going to sit here and just, you know, jinx myself at the same time. Yeah. Oh, honey, I can't wait. Like, I just can't believe, like, 2 years later, I met a friend on the internet on Gays of the Week. That tragic story. But, I was on this channel and I, you know, met a little homie and we kind of clicked or whatever. And I was invited to come out to California one summer. So I was like, yeah, let's do this. You know, I've never met this person a day in my life. Took a leap of faith and went out there. Picked me up from the airport, him and his sister, because she is flawless. Her name is Sunshine. Yes, she's flawless. Yes. But It was really cool. You know, they picked me up and they took me all over California and all that stuff. So now, 2 years later, we still friends. And I'm going back to San Diego Gay Pride. We're going to just, you know, throw dust of, you know, sparkles and gold and your man pieces in it. And we're going to be flawless and have a lot of fun. Because last time we went, homegirl got kicked out the club. You know, we was getting turned and, you know, she got kicked out. But that was cool because she changed her outfit and got back in and kept it cute again. But this time, you know, she's above the legal age, so we can get turned again. And we're going to have fun again. And so, yes. Oh, my God. I get to go see my friend Nico. I just been talking. But you know, guys, I'm just so excited for, like, the gay marriage thing. Like, I have this hanging on my wall. And I also have, like, a trans flag, too, because I got to support my girls. Girls like us. Definitely. But, I just want to say, do not be ashamed of who you are. Like, love yourself for you. You're not different. Well, you're kind of different because you don't want to be, like, the next chick. Honey, that's boring. You want to be yourself and you want to be flawless and you want to be great doing it. You know what I'm saying? Nobody can be you but you. My lips are dry, but I'm still cute. Yes. But for real, you know, just be you and love who you want to love and do what you want to do. Don't live your life for other people because that's not going to go anywhere. You know, just do your thing and just trust that everything is going to work out perfectly and just believe in yourself and believe in the things that you want to do and just don't let nobody stop you from doing it because you can do anything. Like, yes. But if you guys are in San Diego and you are coming to Pride, if you see me, just come and say hello. You know, don't be a stranger or whatever because, you know, you guys are my friends. Like, duh. Just because, you know, I ain't met you in person yet don't mean that, you know, I don't know you because we can get to know each other. You know what I'm saying? We can always be cute together. Yes. So, yeah. So, this video is probably going, like, what? I don't know. Yeah. So I'm about to have a very, 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 very crazy weekend. And I cannot wait to come back and tell you guys all about it and show you, like, pictures and all that stuff. And, you know, I just can't wait. Like, I'm gonna just, like, calm down, calm down, calm down. Calm down. Now I gotta go wash my weave and get cute, honey. And I gotta go shave my legs because ain't nobody wanna see a chick walking around with some thought shorts on with some hairy ass legs trying to be cute. And we know that ain't cute. But yeah. So until next time, guys, keep it cute or get cut. Now, bye.